City getting back onto YouTube. Jeez Louise. Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's been a while. Last time I uploaded a video, the world looked slightly less crap. I hope that you guys are doing well, all things considered. There's a lot of things to be considered, but I'm gonna put down this little palm leaf because I don't know why I have it in my hand. So you may have noticed a few changes in my scenery, in my hair, which was totally not planned.
How's your quarantine going?
Let me tell you guys, I've been dyeing my hair for 8 years and somehow I managed to F it up so much that it's now a dark brown when what I wanted was a slightly ashy brown top with a balayage to my natural copper. Nope, I got the bowls confused and accidentally put the copper on the top and the dark, dark coloring on the bottom. Oops. Anyways, don't want my hair to fall out, so it's gonna be like this for a while. Did we like it? Did we not? Let me know down below. Anyways, I am in my new office in my regular house that I've been living in for the past year. And yes, a house tour will be filmed soon. Actually, I promise I'm finally getting this house around to what I want it to be aesthetically and interior design wise and all that stuff. And I know I make a lot of promises, and I have been making a lot of promises this past year about videos that I never ended up filming, but I'm not gonna make any excuses besides the fact that I feel like I haven't been here on YouTube recently. And yes, I know my last video was about 2 months ago, but I mean more in the sense of present with you guys and mentally here as well. And I don't want to spend ages explaining why I haven't been here, and I also don't really want to get into the details just because I feel like certain things can be kept private. And I've been more of a private person, I noticed, the past few years, and I hope you guys are okay with that, just because I would like to keep my personal life personal and my public life, which is still me. But I feel like in the past couple of years, I've learned what to keep to myself and what to share with others. And I hope that you guys can respect that decision. I know that that won't be an issue for probably all of you, but I feel like there's been a huge disconnect between us this past year especially. And I want to mend that gap and hopefully work towards a better future with videos and content and recommendations and reading and also stuff that I don't really talk about on this channel, like interior design and fashion and makeup and skincare. And this channel is still gonna be primarily about books, but I also want to bring a little bit more of Sasha into it in a way that shows you guys who I am as a person in my day-to-day life, not just in my reading life. And I hope that you guys will stay around to go see that. I'm really excited for all the stuff that I planned. I feel like now more than ever, we are all bonding in a way we have never bonded before. And I think that there's a beauty to that, even though it is created amongst horror. And I feel like when there's such turmoil happening in the world, we need to kind of grab onto that hope and use it to propel our love for one another forward into communication in different various forms, because we obviously are not supposed to be mingling with one another in person, but you know, we can definitely do so online, and communication is vital with people who are your loved ones, your partners, your relationships, your boyfriends, your girlfriends, your whoever. You need to show them your love, and you can do that through communication and through different forms of that. And I think that we have some wonderful communication skills that we have thought about a lot in the past, more in the fact of entertainment rather than connection. And that's why I wanted to come back to YouTube right now, because I think that now more than ever is a good time to reconnect with you guys, just like I feel like we're all doing in our day-to-day life with this shift in the world. But guys, I hope that you can accept my apology and understand that yes, I'm not the old Sasha, but I hope that you will be here for the new Sasha, because I feel like there's this bad connotation towards being somebody new even though you're still yourself, because that comes with age, and I'm not the 15-year-old I used to be anymore. I'm 23 years old now. I am growing up, and that is not a bad thing. I really get disheartened when I see those comments saying we miss the old Sasha, because it makes me question, do they miss the me that used to just like binge read all the time and just talk about books and that was their whole entire world? Or do they miss me and my personality that I've been lacking this past year? Or is it a little bit of both? I think that it's a little bit of both, but that's why I really wanted to go and think to myself about who I am, who I want to be, and I finally came to peace with me. And I wanted to do that outside of YouTube and not be trying to force out content while trying to rediscover who I am. Because I never really lost myself, but I needed to find myself beyond social media and in particular YouTube. And Instagram is a different kind of force for me. I love going over there. It's such a positive community. And I feel like I just got really disheartened by the creative factor of YouTube because I was not reading as much. And I'm still not reading as much as I used to, mainly because I'm an adult now and I have responsibilities. But that doesn't mean that I'm not reading. I'm still reading about a book a week, but I just don't read, you know, 3 books a week anymore, and that is completely fine. And sometimes I don't read any book on any week, and that is fine too. And I think that we need to share that with others, that it's okay to not be reading all the time, and it's okay to be a slow reader, it's okay to lose interest in a book. Because I feel like when you're a booktuber, you are looked at as a kind of book god or goddess or whoever the frick you want to be. And it's a lot of pressure to be this certain type of person in any means when you have an audience, but especially in the means of direction for many people. And I felt like I lost my own direction, and then you guys lost sight of me, and you lost your connection to me. And I'm so sorry, and I can only say that I hope that the future will be better. No promises, but I definitely believe that now I am ready to move forward with a better mindset on this whole entire YouTube thing, and I cannot wait to show you guys what I have in store for you. I am just ready to come back with a good old-fashioned book reorganization video. Oh, but first, because I am really organized and I completely outlined this whole entire video. So before I jump into the organization video, I quickly want to say some things that you have to look forward to on this channel, and also answer your guys' most highly requested question, because so many of you guys have been asking me this, and I've been answering it on my lives, on Instagram, and in DMs, and in comments, but I feel like it's not reaching a majority of you, so I want to answer it here where I know at least a lot of you will watch, hopefully, and that is, what's going on with Project Red, the book that I've written, and also what to look forward to. So first, with Project Red, so many things have been happening since November. If you guys don't know, Project Red is a book that I wrote and have been writing for 3 years, and it is done. I went on submission with it in November, and stuff has been happening since November. I just cannot say anything because of reasons. But don't worry, stuff is coming soon where I will be able to share more information with you, and I'm so sorry I have been so tight-lipped on this. I'm surprised that I've been able to hold all the exciting things from you guys for this long, but I mean, I've not been good. Like, look at me now, I'm like even like, you know, alluding to things, but things are happening, things are coming your way, answers will be had, stay tuned. Also, I completely renovated a lot of stuff since we went into lockdown / quarantine / social distancing / isolation, whatever the frick we're calling it today in these days in general. I've done a lot to this house, and I recorded it for you guys, so a house renovation video is coming soon. I time-lapsed all of it, and I'll kind of talk over certain bits for you in that video, so that'll be coming up very soon. Completely though, just changed my style, and I am loving it, and I feel like an adult now. I also have been reading some incredible books, so tons of recommendations are heading your way. Also, little mini reviews. I'm trying to figure out what exactly you guys want from my channel right now, and so I'm gonna be testing the waters with multiple things. I'll be doing an updated skincare routine, actually just a skincare routine in general, because I never have done one before on this channel, so don't need to update anything. I've been obsessed with skincare and makeup recently, and I say recently as if it's a new thing. It isn't, but I've been really into this stuff for a while, and I want to share that with you. And also, in addition to that, fashion. You guys have been asking me for, you know, my fashion guides and what I wear on a daily, and I'll be bringing you guys like those fashion vlogs and fashion videos soon. And I want to make sure though, it really meshes well with the bookish side of me, so that'll be really fun. I have some good ideas. I'm gonna be doing some bookish inspired outfit looks, and I'm so excited about it. I'm gonna be like pairing up outfits with book covers and also doing like mini cosplays of certain characters. Like, if you want to look like this character, wear these clothes. I'm hyped. Lots of good stuff's heading your way, and I'm really excited to be back, and I just hope that you guys will have me, and I'm just really happy at this point in my life. Okay, I'm done talking about the stuff. Now let's just jump into the reorganization video. Okay, so we all know I am a cooler for reorganizing my bookshelf when it doesn't need to be reorganized because it's in a perfectly understandable manner. And this was totally the case up until I moved into my current place. When we were moving in, I pretty much just threw the books on the bookshelf just to get them out of the boxes, and I didn't touch them since. And yeah, I would go in and dust them off and, you know, clean them, but I wouldn't organize them because as you guys know, if you follow my Instagram, which you totally should, or my Twitter, I am kind of transatlantic now. I am in London a lot of the time and also Boston the majority of the time, but I'm pretty much split my time 4 weeks here, 2 weeks there, up until recently, which has been hard. So because I was kind of traveling back and forth and everything, I never really got around to having just like a day to reorganize my bookshelf, and I didn't feel like it was super necessary just because I was falling in and out of reading, not falling out of love for reading, but just falling in and out of the swing of things with books. And finally, like in the past like 3-4 months, I've been reading like a crazy fiend and I've been loving every second of it. I finally reorganized them with my roommate. She's actually the one that prompted me to do it because right now we have spring cleaning and we're also in lockdown. So what else is there to do besides everything you've been putting off? But the thing is, so usually I organize my books by author, by series, by whatever means necessary that makes sense. But this time around, I did something kind of crazy, and it may seem really, really whack because it is technically not organized by any means besides color, but it looks so nice. And one thing about me is that I know the titles of my books, and I know the spines, and I know the fonts. So once I'm able to kind of live around my reorganized bookshelf for about a month, I know exactly where every single book is, even if it's out of order. Somebody's trying to break into my Uber account. We should kill them. Our books are our main centerpiece in our home. Literally, you walk into a library and you stay within that library until you go to the kitchen where it's just a normal, boring kitchen. They're our main focal point, and so we wanted to make sure that when we were going to be organizing them this time around, we wanted to make it really like nice to look at. And something different that we haven't looked at since we started living together like almost 4.5 years ago. So Sam showed me this picture. I loved it, and I loved the way that it was very uncluttered and very beautiful, and I really love art, and I saw this as a work of art. So we were gonna go and do it. I set the cameras up and we went about our business, and I will show you that now. We had to actually take off all the sleeves from the books and then I organized them. But the thing is, I never was really a fan of book sleeves because they always would come off no matter what. I never really read a book with its sleeve on. I know it's to protect the book, but I'm like, a book will be loved, a book will be banged up, and sometimes maybe eaten by one of your dogs. Fraser ate so many of my books. Oh, we also have another dog now, Chewy. He's the cutest little bean ever. He's a little Yorkie. He's Sam's dog, but we all are family, so they're all of our dogs, and it's amazing. So Sam did a lot of the really heavy work, I would have to say, when it came to taking off all the sleeves. I did that more towards the end because what I had to do at the very beginning was go through the books that I wanted to keep, the ones that I wanted to give away, which was something that I did last year, so I actually didn't have that many that I wanted to give away, but there were a few that I was like, you know what, this will be better going to another home once we're able to leave lockdown. I thought that it was a great method, and actually probably this whole entire process took about 3 hours, and that's the quickest time it's ever taken us to organize our bookshelves. I ended up going and doing a little bit of a different type of pattern to our console bookshelf. So we have 2 bookshelves below our TV. They're shorter than the Billy bookshelves we got from IKEA. They're still Billy bookshelves, but they're just like half size. And Sam recommended kind of doing like a layered look with the pages facing outwards, and I don't think that we're going to end up keeping it looking like this, mainly because I still have a lot of books in the paperback section, which they are all of the paperback variety, but I still have a lot of books in that section that I still need to read and I need to be able to find easily, so I think that we're gonna do something else with that. But as of right now, this is how it looks like. But yeah, the whole entire process went really smoothly, and I think that it looks beautiful. We didn't really want to do a rainbow bookshelf because we did that before, and I don't know, like, I feel like this type of styling looks way more not adult, because I don't believe that there's a correlation between certain colors and adulthood at all. I think that it is very fluid to whatever you want and makes you happy, but I really love just the dynamic of the colors kind of being blocked off and with the black in the middle, because there are so many black books. I swear, if Project Red has a black hardcover, I'm going to scream, like a pterodactyl scream. All in all, I think that the color scheme and the layout and the everything looks so good, and I'm super happy that we were able to do this and it turned out so nice. Follow me on Instagram at Sasha Allsberg, and yeah, let's ride out this pandemic together and let's support each other. And I really love you guys, and I'm gonna go read now. Actually, no, I'm gonna edit this video. Then I'm gonna go read.